today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. It's week 7 of the NFL on EA Sports. Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys taking on Jared Goff and the Detroit Lions.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today we've got a matchup here in pivotal week 7 between the Detroit Lions and the Dallas Cowboys. Joined as always by Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Cowboy team entering play. They've got all W's on the ledger so far, a perfect 6-0.
Yeah, still a long way to go in this season, but they're showing everyone early on that they intend to be there in the end.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Detroit gets set to go on offense, and it will be the 7th-year pro out of Cal, Jared Goff, leading the attack in his 2nd season as a Lion.
And coming off of an early season open week, and in this situation, what he told us when we sat down with him was he spent a lot of time working on fundamentals, kind of getting back to basics during that time, as opposed to having to worry about healing up or resting up. It's too early in the season. Get back to the basics, get his game going again.
They'll fake the give. Now Goff. And that's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. And even 20 yards and a first down on the game's very first play.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big-time arm strength. Very nice route.
The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. Now it's gone. He's got Lewis. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. He's locked in early. Two nice first down completions to start.
I like the fact that he's seeing the whole field early, spreading it around a little bit in the early going.
Meanwhile, Goff's throw going into the hands of Williams. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Well, only 3 plays in here, but really, Charles, a solid start for this offense, and now we'll see if they can continue their mission to end this drive in 6.
And I wonder if their play caller right now is reflecting on that last big play that they've had on this drive. Do you come back with something similar, or do you have a counter to it to kind of show it and go to something else and create another big play?
They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. 2nd down.
This defense for the Cowboys, they were quite formidable in the win over Philly a week ago.
And one of the key numbers that I look at after every game, total yards allowed. They held them under 200 yards of total offense. Just couldn't sustain much of anything against them. Great job showing them different looks and then attacking.
And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
Well, safe to say the passing game has found a rhythm. He's now 4-4, but might need to be 5-5 to keep this drive going here as they face a 3rd down.
And maybe perhaps you show a running play, right? Maybe a little play action here to go ahead and let him throw the ball downfield. I wouldn't get away from him flinging it because 4-4 already, I think he's got a good chance of picking this one up here on 3rd down.
They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
That's a big conversion there on third down, and this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for three, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a first and goal.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Now gone. Touchdown! Josh Reynolds, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Picking up where they left off before the open week that they had last week as they won going into that. And no signs of being stale.
No, and that's really big for them because there's a trust factor that goes into this. Because what often happens, if you win the game before your open week, you should get more time off. But if you win the game before the open week, get more time off, and don't play well the next time out, that goes away. So they're making a statement that they like that time off.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Cowboys taking the field on offense, and for a seventh season, it's Dak Prescott who brings him out.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 24. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And Charles, you know, something we talked about last week, when you start believing whether you're in the midst of a special season or not. Well, now they're at 6-0. Are you still trying to tamp down the expectations in that locker room?
Well, to me, it's less about tamping down expectations and much more about not getting ahead of yourself as a team. And look, they got to play each game individually, right? Many teams talk about being 1-0 at the end of each and every game each week. To me, you got to understand, you cannot win the Super Bowl in October.
Prescott looks to throw on first. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. The Cowboys at 6-0. What a start to the season for them. And they have certainly got it rolling as of late. Winners of 6 in a row.
And I think this is where, as a head coach, you show your team some trust. Instead of just talking about winning, you know, the very next game, you point out to them, we're on a nice run here, and if we keep doing this, we'll be playing at home in the postseason, and we know that that could ride us all the way to the Super Bowl if we get that done.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. But hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Pollard fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard, that's all, down to the 2. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
All of a sudden, those lanes that were there earlier in the drive dry up near the goal line. That's a good job defensively to diagnose the run and stop it for a very short pickup.
From the the two now, second and goal. Elliott will take this into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. And they would not be denied on the ground, powering it in just one play after they got stopped short.
And how about how many tight ends are on the field? Because in today's NFL, we think of the tight end more as a pass catcher. But this group, they tell them you've got to be able to run block to stay on this team. And they committed to it and got it done right there.
Brett Maher on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Taking it about the one. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. They were winners the last time they took the field, which was 2 weeks ago. They had the open week last week, so this is a squad that should be really refreshed and ready to roll.
I would agree, because when you get that open week after a victory, it does wonders for everyone. Obviously, your body get a chance to heal up, but your mind as well. You feel good about winning, so now you get away from it for a few days, put down the playbook, you know, turn off the film. Just be you. Enjoy that time away, and then you come back ready to go.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score. Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
There, the Cowboys here on third down, bringing in an extra defensive back. Now Goff. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
And that is how you respond after taking one on the chin to begin this game. Give up a first drive touchdown, go back out on defense, and completely shut them down to force a three and out.
Fourth down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit. Fielded at the 33. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just...
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hughes. And the Lions are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dive set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out. The defender certainly didn't forget about him leaking out of the backfield. There was a guy ready and waiting to pick him up in coverage, and that throw had no shot.
Throwing again on second and 10.
Goff.
That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Nothing flashy there, the slant to the slot.
Oh, and the frustration for the defensive guys, because it's a quick play, and you know it's going to be a bang-bang play in terms of the throw and the catch, and then he's able to absorb the contact to complete it.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. First down, Lions on a pickup of 13. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they block well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
On first down, gone. Got St. Brown running the quick slant here. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
They suspected that it was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
From the 25 on second down, Goff. That's taken in, complete to Reynolds. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and three. Goff now looks to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Micah Parsons in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. 7-7, our score after one. First play will be a field goal try. Kicking into a headwind here in the second quarter. Gonzalez's kick is good, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
A kind of a throwback weekend for our primetime games here in week seven. Later tonight, a couple of the great AFC teams of the 70s do battle, the Steelers and Dolphins from Miami on Sunday night. And then tomorrow, Monday Night Football, Bears and Patriots from Foxborough, a rematch of Super Bowl 20. Bears won that one 46-10. But fear not for the Patriots, if I remember correctly, and they've won a few in the years following. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Play action now. Prescott out to his left. Man open downfield is Gallup. He's got it. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That one good for 26 and a first down.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Meanwhile, Dak's throw here pulled in by Hilton. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Prescott. Open man Lamb. It's complete. By the skin of their teeth, they are able to convert on third and inches.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Tackle there by Alex Anzalone. Last run got a couple here, second and 8. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Well, Charles, sometimes we talk about the lengths officials sometimes go to protect star quarterbacks, but that one, that was tough to argue against.
Yeah, and I'm sure that everyone's going to say, hey, we're going to administer the penalty the same way for all quarterbacks. But when it's a star back there, even more so are they going to be diligent about throwing the flag.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. The shotgun, it's Prescott to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free and kept them out of the end zone.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Now Prescott. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, his 5th touchdown now on the year as they have taken the lead. Mara on for the extra point. Makes it 14-10. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's finished off by the touchdown from CeeDee Lamb. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. Not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. They begin the drive with Williams. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
On second and nine, Goff. He'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. Jonah Jackson, former third-round pick, the guilty party. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. To throw is gone. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there. Those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Well, they came up with points in their first two possessions, but it looks like they'll come up empty here on their third drive. The defense finally starting to get locked into them a little bit. Might have to go a little bit deeper into their playbook on their next possession.
And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. And he'll take it just outside the 40. It's a 41-yard punt, but just a net of 31 following the run back. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. Out comes CeeDee Lamb and the rest of the Dallas offense, sitting right around the midpoint of the season on pace for 1,000 yards. Good year so far, and I'm sure film study being devoted to him a little bit more on the other side.
They have to, because the pace that he's carrying right now, if you're pushing a 1,000-yard pace as a receiver, that means he warrants your attention. And right now, precision is going on with their offense. Kind of like that timepiece you wear on your wrist. You know, the good stuff, got to knock that off somehow. Chip away at that time and change things up a little bit and make them go to other things and make them do those things better.
Yeah, try to make him uncomfortable. Not many teams have been able to do that so far this year.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing, Prescott. And oh, he almost had his second pick of the game. Probably should have. And he's frustrated as it falls incomplete.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
Now this is Hilton on the receiving end, and it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 25-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. So they got the deal done, and now he can just focus on football. He's got that behind him, family not going anywhere, staying put. He can focus on football.
And I like how you mentioned the family, because that's a huge part of it, because everyone needs to be happy and comfortable. And, you know, while this process was going on, people had to be wondering, especially within his own crew, are we going to have to move? Are we going to have to change things? Not anymore. They get to stay where they're comfortable and familiar.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. It'll be a handoff to Pollard, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 77 yards on the ground here for Pollard. This is a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Prescott to throw it. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
On that snap, he's a hero of his defense after the play he just made. A one-possession game, and his hit kept it exactly that.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now a give here to Pollard, and here he'll get it down to the 7. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. minutes remaining in this first half of football. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. It's our time, guys. Looking to throw. Prescott. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
That ball is caught. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points.
It took a pretty big risk right there going for it on fourth down. But, hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, fourth down, they went for it.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that makes it a 21-10 game. That time, a 9-play drive. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. And Detroit getting set to go now. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a first and 10. Shotgun snap for Goff. He's got it to Williams. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Oh, and Lewis lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
Schultz, and he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays, and target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target.
First down, Prescott, able to hit his target well. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. So give them the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? You have half the distance to the goal. In any event, that's precious real estate given up.
Now Prescott. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's got to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't it?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be.
And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott, and the Cowboys will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Week after week, Charles, when we see this offense operate, I don't know, they just seem to get more impressive.
They certainly do, and let's face it, it's no surprise they're the best in the NFL in scoring. This team designs things well and executes even better. And here, it only takes a few snaps before they're in the end zone. That's how they demoralize teams. That's how they put them on notice.
Extra point by Moore, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Lions now taking over late in this first half. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. First down. Across the middle, he's got it complete to St. Brown. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Looking to throw again on second down. Goff. He'll go right back to St. Brown. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Goff to St. Brown for the Detroit first down. Goff. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. From the 47, it's second and five. Caught by St. Brown. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. Goff throwing again. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Throwing on second and long. Goff. That'll be caught. It's St. Brown. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. A good pickup, but it will come on what should be the final play in this first half. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. A lot to get to here as some of the division races starting to take shape as we look around the NFL here in week number 7. We'll start up at TIAA Stadium in Jacksonville. And that one just before halftime with the Jaguars out on top. Marvin Jones, 2 touchdown catches on the afternoon. From there, it's off to North Carolina to check on the Panthers at home in Charlotte. And they've got the lead in their matchup with the Tampa Bay Bucks. Sam Darnold, 4 touchdown passes. Lastly, let's check on one final game for you. And they trail that one over the visiting Green Bay Packers. The Packers trying to hold on and claim victory. In the game you're watching, you've seen a strong first half out of Dak Prescott. His 3 touchdown passes have his guys out in front. As we hand things back over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter 3. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. So here are the Cowboys to take over. Their win streak at 6 coming in and counting as they've got the lead right now beginning this drive first and 10. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six.
From the lineman to the guy running with it, that was a well-executed first down by the offense. With two shots left to get the first, you can get a little aggressive here on second down if you want and try for some bigger yardage.
The last run got six, now second and four. Prescott now. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Will Harris. Everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
After the interception, here's Gall. And that's hauled in by St. Brown over the middle. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first and 10, Gall. He's going to get that to Swift underneath, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. So the completion good for just three, and it'll be second down. Now Williams running left, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at six.
Another modest gain there on that one, and I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit on a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, and they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one, haven't they, partner, because they have to be extremely one-dimensional now if they hope to get back into this game. They'll have to do it by throwing the football and hope to have success through the air.
It'll go as a gain of four, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Now Zane Gonzalez for the field goal try. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that'll get the deficit down to 15. Whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime, get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
The defense thought they had that play covered, but it still got driven backward by those blockers. Those types of plays are a key part of any team's offensive game plan. It all starts up front in the trenches.
On play action, Prescott. And he rifles one incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, and it'll bring up third down.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they absolutely fooled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. Ended up with nowhere to throw the football successfully.
And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
I think it's safe to say he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now. But he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. It'll be called just a 22-yard punt, certainly not what he wanted. And the Lions will take over. Detroit's offense ready to take over.
Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Play action. It's gone. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Lewis. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Goff on third down. This pass complete to Reynolds. And he is going to have a Lions first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on third and inches.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Now a give up the middle to Williams. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. From the gun, here's Goff.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown.
And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half, and for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Marr now to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. Get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
And Detroit getting set to go now.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Hey! Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Goff now to throw. And Lewis has it, the tight end.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
Now, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he'll lose yardage, brought down at the 32. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Here's Goff. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down at the 27. That's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again. Well, how about the coverage we just saw him break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
So his third field goal of the ball game brings him a bit closer, but there's no question. They need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And sevens, and probably even eights. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear. They want to close this gap.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Dallas offense set for this next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. Your three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
And Prescott, his third interception. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Now a first down throw. Gone. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. There he goes, left side. Return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind, gonna be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
The best starting field position you could possibly have. First and goal from the one. Now Elliott, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Cowboys are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter.
So they're able to capitalize there on the short field, and that might prove to be the score that turns out the lights.
The party's over. Oh, sorry about that. That's an old reference there, folks. But, yeah, they've been the better of the two teams by far. And that's great complimentary football right there. Defense gets the turnover, sets up the short field, and the offense goes right out and scores to open up a pretty sizable lead.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that will bump the lead up to 26. Kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Now it's gone. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there and take the...
And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs.
And here in the fourth quarter, defensively, you know that you're just going to blanket the field with defensive backs and say, okay, take your best shot. And that time, it's intercepted.
And we've often seen teams go into the prevent early, way too early. And sometimes they get too soft in their coverages. But not in this case. They understood the situation and played it with the proper aggression.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Pollard. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And a short gain down to about the 33.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Will Harris. And the Lions are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Now they get a fourth quarter pick, a little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their 38. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Throwing again is gone. That's taken in, complete to Reynolds. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. Yeah, boy, he had the marker square in his sights, but a good tackle's going to leave him about a yard or so short. The screen gets 7, but it's not enough, and it'll be 4th down.
And that doesn't have to gain big yardage to be an impactful play, because if you get those pass rushers second-guessing themselves, that they might get hit with a screen, maybe you can wind up slowing them down just a step. And if you do that, that's a win for that play.
Desperation time for Goff on 4th. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract. 180!
Mike 27! To the air again. Gone. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
On 2nd and goal, standing alone in the backfield is Williams. He's going to get it running right. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Now Goff on 3rd and goal. Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown, Lions. The 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Lions are able to cut into that deficit. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Gonzalez now to add the extra point. And that'll make this a 19-point game. A 10-play drive that time. And it was Jamison Williams wrapping things up with a touchdown. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Cowboys are able to recover. The 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Hey, watch the slant.
Now Pollard. Romeo Okwara hit on the tackle. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They had the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. Pollard going to try the right side. They'll get it to the 23-yard line. 109 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ball game.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with the lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get 4 downs on first down. They did that, plus 3.
Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. 3 yards remain for second down. Going to run again here with Pollard. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Nice job there finding room to maneuver, and he worked his way into another first down. And look, they had great field position to start, but boy, they've done a nice job taking advantage of it.
Now they're just hoping to cap it off. They'll run with Pollard. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. Was that 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Second down, it's Pollard. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's 1st and goal.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, his 8th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the 1st and goal, and then 1 play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard-charging run. Give it right back to him and let him cap things off.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I know they're not asking me, but I'll give you my opinion anyway. I think it's time to erase that play from the call sheet. I guess they figure with the big lead, they can experiment a little bit. But all in all, just go ahead and put that play on ice.
Cover this one up. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. On first down, gone.
And this a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
To throw once more on second and 10. Goff, he'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Now Goff on first down.
St. Brown has it near the sideline.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And it's second down. To throw is Goff. Trying to lob it in there, but it's incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. When there's extra defenders on the field, dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit into football.
On fourth down, gone. And it's incomplete. They could not convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Cowboys defense is going to get them the football back. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Well, without question, when you force four turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force four turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. He talked about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get five next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for Dallas, their winning ways continue as they get it up to 7-0. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Chicago Bears next week. Meanwhile, for the Lions, the loss here will move them back to 500 at 3-3. And they will be at home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gunn saying